grew up in a Christian home, and anyways, what? Relationship with the Lord, I didn't know about it. It was all religion. And when I realized that God was about relationship, so that was about my freshman year in high school. When I realized that, radical life-changing experience, I recommend it. Anyway, so yeah, my father is a cop. Anybody have a cop as a father? Raise your hand. Great, I'm the only one. Anyway, he is very protective, and I'm his little baby girl, so. Anyway, and so the Lord put in my heart missions and nations and people. I love God, I love people. And my father was like, you what? You know, because he's so protective, and he's like, I don't want you going there. I see what those people are, I don't want you going there. And so he was always filling my dreams. Then I had this wall in my room. It was dedicated to the world. I had pictures of children, the world, and it was my prayer wall. Three times my father has came into my room and ripped it down and told me that I was worthless and that I was the only idiot who he thought that could save the world. And I had numerous amounts of times where my father would come in and trash every single one of my dreams because he didn't want me to do those things. And I don't know if anybody in this place, maybe it's a father or maybe it's somebody else in your life that has tried to come in and kill your dreams. My dad is an amazing man, and I don't want to cut him down because God has totally restored my relationship with him. And that's a whole other story. I've even, Lord's blessed me to write a book about the father-daughter relationship. It's not published yet, but it will be soon. And God is so awesome. And the thing that I learned through this whole experience is that no matter what, worship is your highest form of warfare ever. Every time my dad would come in and tell me that I'd never amount to anything, he'd leave my room in a worship zone, and I was like, thank you, Jesus, that you love me. Thank you, Jesus, that you value me. Thank you, Jesus, that I'm not worthless, but I'm priceless. And so one thing I want to tell you is that even if it's your father or somebody else in your life that's saying negative things over you, God says the opposite. God is always like, hey, you're my mighty man of God. You're my princess warrior. You are mine and you are my beloved and I love you. God is so in love with you and he desires you to reach the dreams that he's placed inside of your heart. And you can do it. He believes in you. He's your biggest fan. He's up there, oh yeah, that's my girl, that's my boy, woo, you know? And he's just so in love with you, so in love with you. And for me, knowing that God is everything in my life. So with your dreams, fall in love with God. Fall in love with Jesus. Fall in love with Jesus and let his love just flow over you, man. Be deeply, because you are, okay, I want everybody to say this. I am deeply loved and I am fully accepted by him. God loves you and accepts you, who you are, how you are, everything. He loves you so much. And so go for your dreams, man. God totally restored my relationship with my father. We were this close and it's amazing. And there was that's such a whole nother testimony in it. But God can do awesome things in your life if you will just yield to him and listen to him and fall in love with Jesus. All right.